You got your watch going good. All my batteries are fully charged. Got all my batteries charged up. My bike battery, my phone battery, my Bluetooth battery, my voice recorder battery, all battered up. Alright, it should take about between 45 minutes and an hour, depending on how much hiking we do. Yeah, well, then I won't have to go out again today, will I? I can hold off buying food till tomorrow. And that's my plan for tomorrow. And I'll be able to hear my Samantha.
What?
I'll be able to hear Samantha if it gets too noisy. I won't be able to hear her. Because I've got the volume turned down. But later on when it's quiet, I don't want her to be too noisy.
But I think some of those ones take like 2 years.
Yeah, John was saying that. He said, you never get a crop in the first year. I've seen the lady of the house. That's the first time I've seen the lady of the house. The woman who lives in that house, really. You okay? Not in the mood? So the first kilometer in about 8 minutes. Hello. I thought that was you talking, but it was the cyclists.
What?
The cyclists.
Yeah. That's right, 14.
I had a couple of zone fives, so taking a few early walk breaks till I calm down. know these two. They're, I think they're mother and daughter. The mother's the one with the poles. And I remember hearing them speaking French once. So I said bonjour to them. They must live on Parkside. So, Harvest Lane, pretty soon we'll be under the canopy. Hopefully the rain won't get through.
Oh, it's not a canopy.
Oh, the canopies. Open the canopies. I remember there was a pirate movie once that we were watching as kids. Splice the main brace and open a can of peas. That's what we thought they were saying. Why do you want to open a can of peas? I think it was probably some sort of kids show. Popeye, maybe. Oh, the dogs. Yeah, open a can of spinach. The dogs are going crazy. Three loose dogs, too. They needed to get out, those ones. So we're going to turn left at the top of this little section and then go left, right, and then left. You think it's too muddy for you?
Yeah. I just think I'm going to be asleep.
All right, well, I'll see you in about 45 minutes. I'll be back. And then I'll probably go shopping on the e-bike to get some more wine and stuff. So I've lost my training partner. They've rushed past my fourth favorite tree. And make the little connection between Maddock Trail and I think it's Todd Trail. No, Mercer. Mercy. I was going to take her on a slightly different route, but she decided it wasn't going to be fun. So I'm going to have to change the title of the show from the Meadows Trail with Mrs. J to the Meadow Trails solo. There's a huge tree. Got blown down pretty much before we even got here. Yeah, I'll take a photograph while I'm at it. Up we go. Now I have to remember to deke to the left. I think I've gone wrong here already. There should be a trail to the right. Yeah. Hello, runner behind. Morning. Yep, this is the turning that I was looking for. Yep, that's the one. It says to Mercer. Mercy. This is it. This wraps around the lower end of Mount Douglas Park as it goes out at Glendenning. I don't often do this trail, not in this direction either. This is normally how I finish my run. Yep, there was another branch that I missed. I could have gone on to this one. Two or three places. I took the middle. Well, I hope Norma's okay with our plan falling out there. But, you know, what can you do? Right. Somebody came barreling through. I did this trail once in the dark. It was even confusing back then. Hello. Hi, dog.
No, I didn't. No.
There's a puppy that needed restraining. He had his own time. Anyway, I've got some hiking coming up soon. I can raise the volume a little bit, I guess. And I could probably, zone three, I just heard that. I can probably get away with trying a little bit of music. Let's see what I can choose for us. Well, this should be good. mind you, this might be a little loud. That's better. And I'll put it away before I waste too much battery. Luckily, there are no lyrics to this one. Up we go. Through the falling trees. They had to cut their way through. They had to use a chainsaw to open up the path. Yep, it's a fair bit of climbing this way at this stage. But it puts us out on the meadow pretty quickly. I wonder if starting the music has stopped the recording. No, that appears to be going still. Let me see how many minutes I have on my secondary recorder. 27 on the secondary. No idea on my primary, because I was pausing and unpausing. In fact, I don't even know if I'm recording now. If I was diligent enough, I could go back and splice it all together. But I'm not. I'll use bits and pieces. And pretty soon, when I get into the meadows, I will record the video trailer. I'm going around to the left now. Once again to the left. Hello. I'm going to interact with somebody. Hi.
I see my boots.
Good call. Waiting in the stream will do that. Clean your boots. Yeah, well, maybe Norma made the right call, because she was anticipating stuff like this. I insisted that there were no streams on this side, but I was wrong. How unusual that I was wrong. I can see the meadows up ahead. As I heard a zone 4 chirping in there. This is where I do my extended video trailer from this next turn up onto the meadows. Okay, so this is the trailer for today's exciting episode of running solo on the meadows, or in the meadows, I should say. I'll decide later whether it's on or in. Okay, back to double fisting. Oh, triple fisting the audio. I got camera audio, phone audio, and voice recorder audio all running at once, so I won't miss one exciting moment. Ah, this is where I take another turn. Going down that way would take me to Blenkinsop. This way takes me right out onto the meadows. Got a bit of climbing to do now. So once we get to a good lookout spot, I will shut the trailer down for a little while until I get to somewhere back in the woods where I can record my audio again. Alright, so this is the first bluff on this side of Mount Doug. Then it goes up, 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 rocks, 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 wet rocks to boot. But that's okay. I can handle this. I've got my trail shoes on. So, without making the trailer too long, I will stop that quite soon and switch back to just the audio recording as I pop out from the second bluff. Pretty much levels off now until I get to the Tombstone Rock. But to hear that, you will have to switch to listening to my show, The Running Jackal. Bye-bye. All right, so back to audio. There we go. This is the top of Blenkinsop Trail. Blenkinsop Trail. There are some puddles here, but I can step around them. The other thing I'm really missing is hearing Samantha at a reasonable listening level. I'm sure you're getting treated to a more subdued Samantha than usual, but I'm not getting her data. It's not coming through. I have chosen to turn her volume down. Alright, so it's mainly running now for the next 20 minutes or so. So I should say that I'm up to about 30 minutes now. Yep, it is muddy. Norma was right. As I approach the Tombstone Rock. From here it's mainly downhill now. And I'll end up going down Harrop, which is one of the steeper trails. But thankfully, I'll be going down it today. I'm hoping that Norma makes the most of this morning. I think she probably, when she normally aborts my plan, she does her own thing. I'm hoping that that's what she does today. Looking through, I heard. And I'm running in a stream. As I flash past the cave. And I go up. Hello, come on by. You have a bigger tribe than we have. Can I go next? Thank you. So two separate groups. One with about 5 people, and the other one with about 2 people. Various numbers of canines and an infant. As I squash through the puddles. Some more blowdown. Pretty soon I'm going to be heading down Harrop. Then I'll probably save what I have on my Sony and finish off with the other one. Alright, so my last audio file on the Sony will be me running the last section home so I can do my little bit of timing editing round about then. It's raining harder again now, so there you go. I got a bit of all the weathers. This is where a lot of the dumb people come. This is another favorite dog walker spot. As I run on the neighbor's grass, just to get out of the roadway, all right, back on the asphalt. I'm going to need my headphones for the edit. I'm going to get it just right for your ears. I just heard a zone 5. So let me walk this little section off. See, now I've got the volume settings for recording all the ambient audio with the Sony. I had to turn Samantha right down because of the proximity to the phone she has. Alright, I'm off again. Pretty soon I'll have 1 kilometer of pavement to go. This is where my trail shoes are superfluous. Hang on a sec, this is a road crossing. Okay, 1K to go. So I should be at 5.3 or something like that. I don't want to tempt fate. I'll leave the phone in its warm little place. It's been working hard for me today. It's been the musical entertainment. It's been the voice recording backup. It's been a lot of things to me today. So that's why I'm going to need my earbuds to edit. I'll have 2 different volume levels to deal with. So I reckon that with enough material. It's nice. The little infant on the bicycle was being told by its mother that when they got home, she would put him on her dad's warm tummy. There you go. Family love for you. This is the Running Jackal 2021, signing out for the first weekend show of 2021. Bye-bye.